Hello. I would like to share my personal experience with generosity and how generosity has helped shape who I am today. When I thought about the word generosity, the first and foremost thing that came to my mind was my parents. I grew up in rural Iowa with parents that exemplified generosity, not just financially. It goes much deeper than that. And I'm blessed and grateful to be able to tell you that both of my parents are still living and still bestowing their generosity. Thinking about my upbringing, I came up with four themes. They were central in our family life. They all start with F, so it's really easy to remember. Faith, family, farming, and frugality. Generosity was displayed throughout these themes, even with the frugality. I'm grateful to say I grew up in a thriving church environment. God was the center of that church, and God was the center of our family. Church attendance, financial support, volunteering time, and leadership abilities, teaching Sunday school, serving meals, teaching Bible school. These were all examples that I saw growing up. So these were all things that became expected of me as I came of age. We rarely missed a Sunday, and we never missed a weekly offering pledge. That generosity of time, talent, and servitude has shaped me to volunteer my time, my energy, my talents, and share in our family's financial contributions. Several years ago, my hometown church decided it was time to expand. They added a new fellowship hall, an elevator for accessibility, and a new kitchen, and a huge Christian education wing. And through the generosity of my parents and people like them, a project in excess of $2 million was paid off in record time, about 2 years from start to debt-free. My parents not only gave finances to the project, but their time and talents as well. My dad personally did the bulk of most of the electrical wiring. My mom painted, cleaned, made meals, did woodwork. This example propels my family and I to contribute to our church with capital fundraising, building projects, pledging, and giving time and talent. If a little church in Iowa can do this, what do you think we're capable of at Emmanuel? I think we're capable of a lot. Family generosity came in the form of needing nothing, being able to enjoy extracurricular activities, and having our college educations paid for in full. My parents live by the adage that you can't take it with you, and they choose to remain generous to family and friends. I often remind them they're generous to a fault, and they shrug and tell me, earthly goods are just that. Growing up on a farm meant that income was never a given thing. My parents would dole out finances annually, only to hope that the good Lord, along with some smart work practices, lots of prayer, and being good stewards of the land, would yield something to live off of. I never knew how risky it truly was until I began to appreciate my steady biweekly paycheck. My parents invested wisely. They took responsible risks, and they came out ahead. My dad, to this day, takes great pride in knowing he successfully managed his farm and his career. Work ethic was strong, and he refused to do any additional work on Sundays, just the minimum. That was that firm. When other farmers were losing their farms in the 80s, my dad was willing to drive a tractor over, lend a hand to a guy who needed it. Generosity then came in the form of manual labor, loaning of needed machinery and tools, and lots of time and work. We appreciated what we had, and knew that not everyone had the same thing. Don't get me wrong, we didn't live high on the hog. That's a corny Iowa reference. Frugality was observed and was necessary. New cars were a rarity, and they were only purchased when the cash was there. And cars were driven for years till another one could be purchased with cash. Vacations were sparse. They just weren't in the budget. I wore lots of homemade clothes, and I wanted for nothing. Lean years were years when the church still got their pledges, and the time and the kids still got what we needed. God remains the center of their lives today, and they continue to live this out daily. What a legacy to leave to my family. I'm forever grateful for their examples. So I leave you with this. Keep God at the center of your life, and live generously and give generously, because you can't take it with you. Thank you.